Hello children, how are you all? This is Sridevi from Tala Padmavati International School, Warangal. Today we are going to discuss a new topic from grade 9, that is history part, French Revolution. Before going to the topic, let me know something more about what is this revolution mean. A revolution is a fundamental and relatively sudden change in political power and political organization which occurs when the population revolts against the government due to perceived oppression or political incompetence. As a historical process, revolution means a movement often violent to overthrow an old regime and effect complete change in the fundamental institutions of society. The goal of revolutionary war, which makes in contrast, is to change the government on the stronger situations, understanding of revolution to make a fundamental change in the government. This French Revolution is one of such revolution which is mostly related to many such situations about the common people and their living conditions. So there are so many such revolutions took place in many of the world countries. Part of the topic, one of the example I would like to say is American Revolution, which changed the society more than the French Revolution, because there was a declaration written before the war and even after the war completion, and the freedom from Britain inspired other freedoms such as the importance for women's rights and slavery. The American society was completely changed for the better because of this situation of revolution. The French Revolution is a very important event in the world history itself because it has given many important aspects like equality, liberty, and fraternity. French Revolution has many reasons like economic, political, and social reasons. So now, let us try to know more about this French Revolution from this lesson, which gives us the detailed information about France, the king who ruled, the main intentions of liberty, equality, and fraternity. So, when we come to the topic, in 1774, Louis XVI came to power from a Bourbon family and ascended the throne of France at the age of 20 years. That was really a very young age. And he married an Austrian princess, Marie Antoinette. But here, Marie Antoinette was not that good advisor to her king regarding the kingdom in suggesting the right ways or supporting the king. But Louis was very kind-hearted and supporting king for the people. And as he became the king of France, part of his financial conditions, he came to know that his treasury was empty. Immediately, he was so shocked as he came to know about the treasury. Being a king, he took an action of finding out the reason about why the treasury is empty. And behind the reason of that treasury, there was a long run of war which made the financial crisis in France. And the actual reason behind this was a long-run war between France and Britain. France and Britain were very close enemies with each other and were fighting with each other from long time. Britain occupied 13 colonies of USA and France was trying to help USA so that USA could get freedom. And due to that, as France was supporting USA, it was even spending money on USA to help that country. Apart from that, even France started taking loans or lending money for very high interest, around 10% from other countries as well. Meanwhile, the situation has come in such a way that they don't have good relationship with the people of that particular country. They were not connected. Even the king was not connected, or the people were not connected with the government. So the king was not in a position to come to a final decision that what to be done during these serious situations. Situation was like too many problems were being faced at a time, like there were no money in the treasury, as we discussed earlier. And secondly was debt with high interest rate, which he has taken to help USA. And he need money to maintain the kingdom, or else the army, or else to look after the people of his kingdom, where they were being directly or indirectly the people of that kingdom, where the king is responsible to look after his people. So all such, apart from these all responsibilities, there are such even where to look after as a king, being a responsible person. After thinking much, finally he came to a conclusion. Being a king, he decided to impose the tax, that is, on the people, by which they can get money to solve or sort out all the problems or the issues which were being facing presently. The king was also only with the idea of imposing tax on the people. More than this, there were no other way to get rid of this problem. So now, being a king, he cannot decide himself to impose the tax rate on the people. According to the France government, the king has to take the permission from the estate general of that particular kingdom, France. This estate general is a political body of France, where the king don't have any right to decide himself. And later we'll be knowing about this estate general, political body of France. And now, to impose the tax, here we see the changes in the French society during 18th century. So the king decided to declare three estates. The first estate was about the clergy. This was maintained by the church people, or as we call the fathers, generally we see in the church. They were the people who maintain the complete responsibility, who were being called as the clergy. They will be collecting the tax under one section of collection. In the second estate, the responsible persons were the nobles or the nobility. They were the feudal lords. And in the third estate, we observe the complete common people of that particular country, like the businessmen, court officials, lawyers, administrators, officials, small lawyers, landlords, and many more, and even the servants. Now here we see the first and second stage people enjoy all the privileges, means all such facilities from free of cost. To say here, all these have such privileges by birth itself. They were so blessed to live with high standard of life in France. and even they are getting or collecting the tax from third estate people. So here the high pressurized life was finally faced by the third stage people who were being forced to pay the tax. And here the first tax paid by nobles to the clergy was known as taithi, which was tax to church. It was out of production paid by the peasants. During this time period of division of estates, finally American USA country got its independence on July 4th, that is 1776. Meanwhile, when we come with the part of tax collection, the other type of tax which was paid to the king was direct tax, and it was called as taili. And the third type of tax they are paying to the nobles was the feudal tax. Even there was the fourth type of tax too, which was not given very clearly, but even this was called as the indirect tax. But even to purchase a common need or the necessity or the a product or a commodity, the people were being forced to pay the tax just to purchase even the salt or tobacco. Apart from the all these, the population of France increased very rapidly from 1715 to 1789. In 1715, France population was around 23 million. But unbelievably, by 1789, it increased to 28 million, which was too high and too heavy. So here, we have to notice a thing. As the population increases, the living condition of the people also to be increased. But something else the situation has brought here in this topic. There is increase in population, but there is no increase in the production. That led to the bitter situation of the people living condition. But the production has no increase along with the population. So here it is very simple to understand, the population is high, but the production is very less. So the France decided to raise the demand of product. As the supply was very less, the cost of the product has reached out of hands. It has rose up to sky. The situation was in such a way that the basic food like bread was very expensive for even the common people who were unable to purchase within the income they got. So the situation has come back again where the poor people were suffering because of high population, high price and more tax. These were the situations faced by the common people of country France, whereas the clergy or the nobles were the people who were been taking the tax from these third estate, as well as making the third estate people to pay the tax for the government also. So now let us move to the next continuation of the topic to know about the strong middle class. So here middle class are the people who also belongs to third estate, but the life or the situation of these people was comparatively good. They are like the rich, educated, aware with the new ideas and demanded society based on equality. Here they were in an opinion that whatever is going on in France is not at all good or correct. They were even suffering for the common bread, which was not even allowed to purchase, or else even the situation was not supporting them, or the source of income was not in such a way so that they can purchase the bread to eat. So the basic food was also not that comfortable in France. Such a bitter situations were being faced by the French people because of such activities which were being imposed by the king or the lords of that kingdom. So, the middle class people were in a strong decision to move out the situations in a better way. The main concept of French Revolution was to equalize the living condition of common man based on liberty, fraternity, and equality. They were the main motto of this French Revolution. So here, the opinion that whatever is going on in the France, according to the middle class people, was completely not acceptable. They were not in a position to accept these all. And they believe that the facilities given by birth is not at all correct or fair. How can a person be decided to be given all the facilities right from the birth? They were thinking the society on equality and freedom. They were opposing the dictatorship of single authority, not allowing the people to be free in their living conditions so that they can raise the voice and fight for equality. Now let's move to the next continuation of the topic to know about the strong middle class. So here middle class are the people who also belongs to third estate. And here compared to poor, their financial conditions are good as they are well educated. They were like rich, aware with the new ideas and demanded society based on equality. They were the people who raised the voice to fight against the kingdom and the king of France to give the equal status to every individual citizen in France. According to their demand, they were saying to give the importance even to the third estate people. And that famous or the very important people in our lesson were about the great philosophers like Rousseau, John Locke, and Montesquieu. They were in an opinion that whatever is going on in France is not at all good or correct. And they believe that the facilities given by birth are not at all fair. John Locke has written the book called The Two Treaties of Government. He refuted the doctrine of divine and absolute right of the monarchy, where he has given the importance to give equal status to all the people in his book, which is called as Two Treaties of Government. And Dr. Locke says that there must be doctrine democracy, where the people take the decision and not the absolute king or the absolute power or the dictator. According to Rousseau, he written a book called as Social Contract. It basically talks about the relation between the king and the people. In the same way, even Montesquieu also written a book called The Spirit of Laws. In his book, he mentioned that there must be division of power between the legislature, executive, and judiciary. And in his model of government was implemented in USA. When USA got the independence in 1776, 4th July, they implemented this model in USA, where there is a division of power between legislature, executive, and judiciary. And they also
gave the basic rights to the citizens, where they have given the equal status to all the people of the country in USA. And here, that new change or the positive change of these thinkers inspired the political thinkers of France too. So this made a way for the France to think that this type of system must be there even in France also. As the opinion was to promote the ideas of equality and freedom along with the liberty. They were trying more to improve the situations and give the equal status. Finally, France got its importance in giving the status of equality, liberty and freedom to the country. That's all from this lesson. Thank you.